Are you troubled by weak network signals at home or dead spots in the network? So how to resolve them? Okay, wireless APs or Wi-Fi extenders can solve this problem, but which one is more suitable for you? Firstly, let's understand their respective modes of operation. Wireless AP is usually used with AC. AC is responsible for managing all wireless APs in the wireless network, and AP is responsible for accessing the wired network. When setting up, if you use an independent AC, it's responsible solely for data forwarding and management. You still need a network cable to connect the router to access the network, and a PoE switch to power the APs. However, some brands in the market integrate AC, router, and even PoE functions into one unit, simplifying connections to just an AC and AP. And Wi-Fi extenders aim to extend coverage and improve signal strength, enhancing the ability to penetrate walls. They receive the wireless signal from the main router, amplify it, and then extend it so that you can access the internet even in the dead spots where you can't connect to the internet. The biggest difference from AC plus AP setups is that Wi-Fi extenders operate entirely wirelessly. You only need to power on the extender, connect your phone or computer to the extender's default signal, and successfully configure it with your main router's Wi-Fi. These two networking methods have their own advantages and disadvantages. The greatest advantage of an AC plus AP setup is seamless roaming support. This networking method supports 802.11k V4R protocols to ensure that you can switch smoothly without interrupting the network connection wherever you go in the house. Conversely, with Wi-Fi extenders, because devices need to switch between the extender's signal and the main router's signal, so even if it is placed in the most reasonable position, you will still have a short network disconnection phenomenon of a few seconds during the movement. Moreover, the AC plus AP setup supports more user connections. A typical home AP can support 10 to 20 terminals. With broader transmission ranges, it ensures optimal network performance for each client, avoiding network congestion and performance degradation. In contrast, the number of devices connected to a Wi-Fi extender depends on the main router's bandwidth. The network speed of the extended Wi-Fi is generally only half of the original speed. If the signal passes through the wall, there will be even greater loss. However, compared to the cumbersome wiring required for an AC plus AP setup, the biggest advantage of Wi-Fi extenders is their wireless connection, easy installation, very suitable for families who don't have wiring in each room at home. And compared with the high price of AC plus AP combination, a Wi-Fi extender can solve the problem for only a few dozen dollars. Therefore, if you don't demand extreme network speeds and there is no wiring at home, we recommend choosing a Wi-Fi extender. Conversely, if you seek high speeds, have a large home with existing wiring, we recommend an AC plus AP combination. Next, let's use a house floor plan to explain specific installation positions. If you choose to use Wi-Fi extenders, place the main router in the living room and the extender slightly further in the dining room, avoiding walls as much as possible to prevent network speed impact. If you want to set up AC and APs, place the AC in the weak current box, one AP in the living room, and one in each of the other bedrooms. Choose between in-wall or ceiling-mounted APs based on room requirements. We provide both types. Please click qsfptech.com for consultation. Finally, if this video is helpful to you, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel.